Okay, so that's what we have seen. This is the normal magnetron which has been arranged following the condition of self consistent, and now we are checking out at the different magnetic fields how the trajectory paths of electron has been taking out. And with this we have seen these four conditions. And first, as in the absence of the magnetic field, as it has been recording, so that I'm just repeating it a small briefly. As the magnetic field has been zero, so it has been almost all taking the straight line to move the electron from cathode to anode. And if the magnetic field, which has been just increased and but maintained less than the critical magnetic field, then it shows in a curved nature. So it has been moving to the cavity a little bit later than that of the electron A. So this is the path followed by the electron B. Next, if the magnetic field which has been applied is almost equal to the critical field, critical magnetic field. So what is this critical magnetic field? So it's nothing but whenever the electron, it just starts its journey from cathode and moves towards the interaction gap, thereby reaching to the anode. And after that, it has been returning back, just grazing the surface of the anode cavity, returning back to the cathode once again. This is been absorbed at a certain magnetic field. At what magnetic field this electron has been grazing and returning back towards the cathode is said to be critical magnetic field. Okay, so this is the path followed by the electron C. It has been approximated. And the fourth category, if the magnetic field has been still increased, that is greater than the critical magnetic field. Now, instead of moving the electron towards the cavity, it totally avoids, because the magnetic field applied has been more, so it won't spend maximum time in the interaction space towards the moving towards the cavity. So it's keep on reflecting on the surface of the cathode. Okay, it will keep on moving or reflecting on the surface of the cathode. So this such type of electrons is being categorized under electron D. Okay. So these are the categories of the R, the trajectory parts of the electrons, which moves from cathode to anode because of all the four different conditions of magnetic field which is being applied. Okay. Now, you might be noticed or not, I have not yet used the term RF field till now. Okay. So these are all in the absence of RF field. Now I'm going to explain the working of magnetron in presence of RF field, how they are going to vary and how the oscillations will be generated, how it gives up the energy. Okay. Now, moving to the next diagram in presence of RF field. So for that, I'm taking one of the diagrams where it's been of the five cavities has been taken out. So for that, so I'm taking five cavities here. You can also take all the eight cavities also, no issues. So I'm taking all the cavities over here. So these are the five cavities we have. Okay. So these are the five cavities which is being considered. Now we are going to check out, this is the cathode at the center. Cathode, and these are the cavities. Now we'll see, we have some RF field which is being present, and the electric field, as I told, it is also having an electric field. So let me represent the electric field which is being provided, which is being taken in this case. And the electric field is being totally, it is being very easy to represent. And what are the ways, how the field direction is being taken out? I'm going to represent that. The electric field is being totally given as the polarities, taking as anode and the positive and negative polarities. In that way, it is being taken out. And just let me take like this. These are the electric fields. And the direction is also mentioned over here. Now we can see approximate this. These are all the electric fields. So these are the electric field lines and how it is being influenced as it is being providing both electric fields and magnetic fields together. So I am just, this has been how it is being represented, the electric fields. With this, now let us consider what will be the trajectory paths when the electric field is being present and also the magnetic field which is being influenced. Okay. Now it has been some RF field. It has been involved with some RF field. The RF field, I'm just representing that like this. So this is the RF field which is being given into the cavities, influencing to the trajectory paths of electrons, which generates the oscillations over here. Now for that, so with this, let me consider the path followed by the electron when it is being moving out into the interaction gap, how it behaves. So first initially, it will, let me consider in presence of RF field, where the electric field lines upon influencing the magnetic field, how the electrons it is being moving, thereby it gives out the oscillations to the tube, from the tube. Okay, so for that, so first I am considering as the trajectory path of electron A, so where it starts its journey. Whenever it is being followed, it is being moving over here, it tries to move initially towards the straight line actually, because of the magnetic field which has been influenced, it bends to the trajectory path has been, it has been affected. Okay, so that it moves to the field, let this be a first field. Then after that, it moves to the field, second field, and moves to the third field of electric field, and finally it reaches to the point that is at anode. Okay, so these are the electrons. So these are the electron A, where it is been following this trajectory path in presence of magnetic field and electric field and the RF field which has been applied. Okay, so due to this, what happens when it enters to the electric field, it has been absorbed over here. It gives out the oscillations. So this electron A will use out the oscillations. Okay, oscillations is being provided. And after that, when it is been moving to the electric field lines of the other cavity over here, so once again it starts giving out the oscillations. Okay, so due to which the oscillations are generated within the magnetron tube. So whenever it is being keep on influencing with the electric field, then at that particular time it gives out the energy that is in the form of the electric in the form of oscillations. Oscillations are generated and that is being taken out from one of the cavity output over there. Okay, so that is how the oscillations has been produced by the magnetron. Suppose if you take another electron, So where the another electron which is being taken out. So in this case, you can see here. So such type of electron is being considered as a B electron over here. And we can observe that this electron B is being not at all moving towards the electric field lines over there. So before that, it is being just returning back towards the cathode. So due to such behavior, there is no chance of generation of the oscillations because of such type of electrons. So hence, the electrons A is considered to be favored electrons. And whereas electrons B, which has been not giving out the oscillations, has been considered to be unfavored electrons. Okay. So such number of electrons C and D. Similarly, we have other electrons also that is being taken out. The electrons C and B too have enough electron D. The electron C and D, where they cannot, there is a possibility that they are influenced by less number of electric fields. Whereas electron A, it has been influencing by the three electric fields over here. Okay, as it takes path from anode to cathode, from cathode to anode. Whereas B and C, you can see that electrons C and D. So where, so this D is being taken out, influenced only at this particular electric field, and C is being influencing both this particular electric field and this particular electric field, and thereby reaching towards the anode. So whenever it is being influenced by the electric field, they give up the oscillations. So D electron influenced by this electric field giving up the oscillations. So these are the property of the electrons, where such number of A group electrons, C group electrons, and D group electrons, which is been giving out the oscillations whenever it is being influenced by the electric field. And those are considered to be the favored electrons. Okay. But the producing of oscillations will be different. As more the influenced by the electric field, more amount of oscillations will be generated. Whereas you can see that C is being influenced by only these two electric field, whereas D electron is being influenced by only this electric field. The generation of oscillations will be accordingly it has been influencing. Okay. So it will be less by C and D, but more with the electron A. So such type of electrons has been categorized as favored electrons, and whereas B group electrons is being considered as unfavored electrons, where it won't provide any oscillations. So this is the working functionality of magnetron in presence of RF field. Now a small group, we can observe that the B electrons, it has been spending its less amount of, it will keep on rotating as it's revolving around this cathode. So which may generate a heat will be generated. So that should be generated towards up to a tolerant level. Beyond that, it should not be increased. It's the amount of heat should not be increased. So for that, so one more a group or a cloud-like structure is being formed with such type of B electrons, that is favored electrons and unfavored electrons. So let me draw a final diagram where the cloud representation of the magnetron is being represented. So for that, I am taking it as another diagram where it is a cathode. This is a cathode, and we have the representations. So it is being taken as the representation of eight cavities over here. In some textbooks, they have given a full cavity diagram. You can also draw even that also. No issues. Both can be considered as enough correct one. So these are the eight cavities which satisfying the self-consistent property. Okay, so now with this, let me consider the cloud representation, how it has been taking place. the cloud representation because of the electrons B. It is being considered as unfavored electrons as it is being keep on rotating around the cathode. So a bunch of electrons, it is being available over here at the cathode, and the remaining electrons A, C and D, they are reaching towards the anode cavity, and such type of cloud representation is being given like this. So this is the cloud representation where it is being taken at alternate cavities, where it is being taken at alternate cavities, the cloud representation is being taken out. See, these are the cloud representation. We should be keep on moving in the clockwise direction. This cloud representation is moving in the clockwise direction because of the electrons. There is because of favored electrons and unfavored electrons. Okay. So as the electrons will be keep on generating and from try to move from cathode to anode, and during which the oscillations has been provided. This is a cumulative process. It will be keep on taking place, due to which there is a movement of this cloud representation within a clockwise direction. And this is how the cloud representation, due to the unfavored electrons, that is B electrons, and because of these cloud representation due to favored electrons, that is given by C, A, C and D are the favored electrons. So this is how it has been called as cloud representation of magnetron, due to which the favored electrons and unfavored electrons have been clearly differentiated based upon the diagram over here. So this is the entire working functionality of the magnetron, and the process of forming the cloud representation of favored and unfavored electrons is being called as phase focusing effect. It is being called as phase focusing effect. So this formation of cloud representation because of favored and unfavored electrons is termed to be phase focusing effect. And that's what the four diagrams you need to draw if they ask in the examination. And this is the pi mode of operation. As I have told, there is a how when it is being considered to be a pi mode of operation and when it is being considered to be a zero mode of operation, I have already given it to you. So a small expression is being used to know what is the representation of the pi mode and zero mode, where we have taken as an average phase representation. It has been given as 2 pi n by n over here. If we take n here, n is equal to n by 2. Whenever we take n is equal to n by 2, so even term, then if you substitute over here, n by 2, and this n, this 2 and this 2 will be cancelled. The left out term will be pi. So pi average will be equal to pi. Then we can say that the magnetron is been operating in pi mode of operation. When we take n equal to 0, okay, when you substitute n equal to 0 over here, so then it will be in pi average will be equal to 0. Then we can say that it is a zero mode of operation. And the standard mode of operation of magnetron is the pi mode of operation. So whatever I have explained till now with all the 8 cavities, it is for the pi mode operation. So this is all regarding the pi mode of operation. Now a small derivation we have related to the amplification process, how it has been taking place and what are the approximations is it been considered. Okay, so it's been somewhat big derivation, just two pages it may take. The derivation of amplification process, how the oscillations has been provided, and for that it is being taken as a radius A here for the cathode, and from here to here the radius B is being taken. Okay, so R will be equal to A, it gives the radius of cathode. R is equal to B, it gives the radius of the anode. Okay, so now let me proceed how the derivation is being taking place using the concept of the magnetron, so whatever we have discussed till now. And I also informed you that these are the trajectory paths of the electron, and these trajectory paths is being taken out whenever we have, in the absence of RF field, the radius can be calculated. The radius of such trajectory paths can be calculated as R is equal to MV by E into B. Okay, where R is the radius of this electrons which is been influencing over here, and M is the mass of the electron, E is the charge of the electron, V is the velocity with what velocity the electron has been moving from cathode to anode, and B is the magnetic field which has been applied. Okay, and it has been found that these two are directly proportional. The radius is been directly proportional to the velocity of the electrons, and whereas it has been inversely proportional to the magnetic field. So as the magnetic field increases, the radius of that electron will be decreased over here. So that is the another expression we have used earlier. In the absence of RF field, so we can calculate the radius of the electrons which has been influencing based upon the various magnetic field which has been applied. Okay, now we'll see the amplification process, how it is been taken out. What is the amplification process and how it is been calculated? Okay, we'll see it now. Based upon that, whatever the discussion we have made till now regarding the magnetron, we'll extend the discussion using the conditions over there. We'll see the amplification process. So this is the amplification process. So it has been not much complicated as it has been discussed in case of two cavity or the klystron amplifier. Okay, so there are big derivations we have, and which we have discussed the first one before the mid one, and the second one mid two we have discussed. Now this is the amplification process. It's been very simple, not that much complicated as we have seen earlier. So for that we need to consider the magnetron, and this magnetron, the diagram, the cylindrical structure I am going to consider. See, the meeting is going to end up within 2 minutes only. Please join back. I'll be finishing up this derivation. It may take another 5 to 10 minutes, and after that I will be winding up the class. Okay, so I hope the strength has been 77 including me, and all 77 will be returning back. And it's been a surprise if it has been more than 77, and I won't expect more than 77. And now it has been taken as a cylindrical structure which has been considered the magnetron. Okay, so where we have a cathode in the center. So this is all the anode cavity, this is the cathode, and from this the cathode, so it is being taken like this. So this is the cathode at the center, and outward it is all the anode here. Okay, then here the cavities will be done over here, and time permits I'll be showing the diagram, actual diagram, how it will be. You can see the actual diagram of the magnetron. I'll be showing it. So this is how the cylindrical structure of magnetron which is been done. So there will be 8 cavities, and the anode to cathode will have in a power supply, and this is the internal diagram of the magnetron which have an 8 cavity over here. Okay, so based upon that I have drawn the cavities over there. Okay, and now coming to the amplification process, here it is been taken as a cathode. This is the anode with various radius, and we have the electric field and magnetic field which has been applied on it. So it has been axial. The magnetic field will be of axial, and the electric field will be of the radial. Electric field will be radial. So with this representation, I am going to derive in a small derivation.